Hi, welcome to my 7th video about Qt for Nokia phones. In this video we will introduce you to button element from Qt Quick Components. Also, we will be using text and rectangle element. We will tie all these things together with a few simple lines of code written in QML. You are just looking at the final project run in simulator. When the app starts, the rectangle is yellow. On the top we have text element. Beneath we have a rectangle and under we have buttons. At the bottom we are using toolbar. We covered toolbar in our Hello World Explained tutorial, so be sure to check it out if you haven't. When we press buttons on the screen, the rectangle changes color and also text is updated. When we go back, the app closes. We will close the simulator for now. Let's take a look at the code. I didn't mention it last time, but I guess you figured it out yourself. QML supports nesting of elements. Page stack window is top level element and toolbar layout is its child. This means that page stack window is parent of toolbar layout. Toolbar button is child of toolbar layout. This parent-child relationship is useful when we want to position elements one according to other. So we can see that bottom of toolbar layout is anchored to the parent's bottom. This means page stack window's bottom. It means that toolbar layout will be on the bottom of the screen. You have also probably noticed that Qt Quick colors syntax. Elements are colored in violet color and their properties are colored in this red color. Strings are green and comments are green too. Let's get started. We will close this project, go to File, Close All Projects. We will save if we want to. We will create new Qt Quick project. We have covered this in earlier tutorial. Be sure to watch movie Hello World for Symbian free video if you haven't seen it yet. You can find the link in the description below this video. Go to File, New File or Project, choose Qt Quick Project, Qt Quick Application. Choose a name, I will call it Rectangle Color. It will be saved in Qt Work Learning. You can choose folder which you desire. We will choose Qt Quick Components for Symbian and I will choose only target Qt Symbian. No version control and finish. Okay, so basically this is skeleton code generated for you by the Qt Creator Wizard. We have page stack window, toolbar layout, so this only creates a toolbar you have seen in the simulator before. And it is putting the file main page QML on the stack so you can see it. We won't modify this file at all. Let's open main page QML. Okay, here it is. So we have got page element, it's top level element, and inside we have text element. Text element just says hello world. I want to stress that everything written in code in edit mode is visible here. So you can see page element has ID set to main page. And you can see that here in designer, we are going to switch in designer mode now. Page element has an ID set to main page in edit mode. And you can see that here in designer mode, top level element in navigator is called main page. And in properties pane, you can see its ID is set to main page. We have set that in code. Also, if you click on text and you change some properties in properties pane, like property text, you will see the code updates automatically. Change the text in designer so it says my hello world. You can also change the text color to red. We can see in code the changes we made in designer mode. Okay, let's get back to designer mode. We will add a button and a rectangle. Okay, here it is. To our main page. When I move things around, you can see that the guidelines are popping on the screen, so they help me to arrange the view. Now let's arrange these elements. Select the text element, and here in Properties pane, under Layout, we can set top anchor, target will be parent, and margin, we can set margin to, I don't know, 100. Okay, we have to move a little bit down the rectangle now, so we can see text element. Okay, we can also change the color of the text element to, let's change it back to white, and also we will change the size. Let's change it to 30, maybe, put it in the middle, and under layout, it's still in the middle. Okay, now we can arrange the rectangle. We will set left anchor and right anchor to the left and right boundaries of the main page file. Parent main window 80. Okay. Now let's make it 10, maybe 20. Okay, this looks nice. Okay, so we set right anchor to the parent main page, 20 pixels from right margin of the main page. And our button is positioned nicely. So this ensures us, if we rotate orientation of the page, that our rectangle will be widened. So it will always be 20 pixels from the side borders of the main page. Okay, so let's get back to edit mode. We can see that some new objects appeared. There are some new properties inside text element. We have defined color. Horizontal alignment is binded to text align center. So this is a text inside the text element. Anchor top is aligned to parent top with margin 100. Anchor horizontal centered, parent horizontal centered. So this is positioning for the whole text element, and this positions the text inside the text element. So we can have text aligned to the center or to left or right. Font size is set to 30, of course. And now we will change ID property of the button. So it will be BTN green, because this will be button for color green. And label of the button will be also green. Okay, rectangle has ID rectangle. We can change color of rectangle to yellow. This is a RGB coding of color, but we can just type yellow here. And anchors of the rectangle, we can see that we set parent right with margin 20. Anchor left, parent left with margin 20 also. Now we will make this button do something useful. We will create onClicked signal handler. This handler is called when there is a click. Since our signal handler is inside the button, it will be executed when button is pressed. When the green button is pressed, we want to change the text from the text box so that it says color green. So let's write line of code that does this. Rectangle's color should also be changed to green. We will also add this code. And finally, we want to write something to the console log. We will write green button pressed. Now, let's modify our rectangle. We will change height property of the rectangle. Rectangle height will be calculated and it will amount to parent's height divided by 3. Because of this, rectangle will have different height in portrait mode and different in landscape mode. So in portrait mode it will be higher, in landscape it will be shorter. Okay, so let's build this. Save all changes to the document. Build is running. And let's run this. In simulator, our rectangle is yellow. Height of the rectangle is parent's height divided by 3. When we hit the green button, the text of the text label is changed to color green. Color of the rectangle is changed to green. And when we rotate the simulator, then the height of the rectangle is height of the parent divided by 3. We can see that we have to adjust the position of button, and there is too much space from the text to the top of the screens. In our next tutorial, we will adjust the position of the elements on screen, and we will add 2 more buttons. The final program will be usable in portrait and in landscape mode.